Hello dear student, I welcome you all in Highway Engineering subject and the subject code is 1615504. Today we are going to see unit number 5, that is Traffic Engineering. In that, this is lecture number 3. Myself Daniel Swami, I am lecturer of Civil Department, GEMS Polytechnic College, Aurangabad, Bihar. Let us discuss about the content of this lecture. In Traffic Engineering, today we will see the introduction on road making, color pattern for marking, classification of road marking and road studs. Let us discuss about these four topics in detail. First of all, we will see the introduction part. In that, we will see what is road marking. Road marking are lines, patterns, word which are applied or attached to the carrier base. Road marking is normally indicate longitudinal marking, transverse marking, text and symbol, etc. on the road surface. Road marking is nothing but it gives the marking of line, pattern and word, as well as road marking is normally longitudinal marking, transverse marking and marking on marking of text and symbol, and it can be marked on road surface, and this line, pattern and words can be marked in carriageway. You should keep in your mind, in carriageway we should give a road marking in line, pattern and word. In road surface we should give in longitudinal marking or transverse marking or text or symbol. Okay, next is why we need road marking. For guiding and controlling traffic on a highway or and serves as psychological barrier. This marking gives you a psychological, in human mind, it shows a psychological barrier for guiding and controlling traffic on highway, channelizing the pedestrian and cyclist movement into a safe location, which channelizes the traffic movement also and the cyclist as well as footpath also to move in safety. But if we are violating the rules and regulation of traffic, it will cause you accident. Next one is color pattern of marking. As I have in this PowerPoint, I have made according to the color. As we can see here, white color. White because of the visibility and good contrast against the road surface. The white color should be widely used for road marking. As we know, in road is in black color, the center line marking and shoulders marking will be done in white color. Yellow marking will be longitudinal marking, where to convince the message that it is not permitted to cross this marking. It is also used to show parking restriction and to impose other traffic control. This yellow line shows parking restriction and also to impose other traffic controls. Blue line indicates a new and a special marking which are not conventional. Blue is a color of a public transport that indicates three-wheeler, scooter and rickshaws. As we can see, blue color which indicates the public traffic, that is three-wheelers vehicles, that is scooter and rickshaws, and this is special and new indication and new marking which is not a conventional. Okay, next one is green color. That green color marking is designated that bicycle and non-motorized transportation facilities provided on road. Green color background should be marked at the intersection to give priority to the cyclist and pedestrian in the crossing road. Green color give the priority to the cyclist and pedestrian in a crossing of crossing the road. Red and purple were used for multiple roads user and are sharing the road spaces on hazardous locations, that is dangerous location. Red color marking is primarily used for helping people to understand the danger. Red marking is highly recommended on hazardous intersection and also at the place where pedestrian traffic conflict with more motorized traffic. These are the places where the red and purple marking of sign will be done. Next one is classification of road marking. Let us see the classification of road marking. Pavement marking are broadly classified into following 7 categories based on the placement of marking. First one is longitudinal marking. Second one is transverse marking. Third one is hazardous marking. Fourth one is block marking. Fifth one is arrow marking. Sixth one is directional marking. Seventh one is facility marking. Let us discuss about these markings for a clear understanding of road marking. First one is longitudinal marking for undivided roads. As you can see in this image, there is edge line and center line and the lane line. This shows the longitudinal marking of undivided roads. Longitudinal marking are the middle block section for a single intermediate lane road where the carriage way is less than 5.5 meter. And then if the carriageway is less than 5.5 meter, then this longitudinal marking for undivided roads will be placed. Longitudinal marking at the mid block section for two-way roads where carriageway is 5.5 meter to 7 meter without any pavement shoulder, and this also shows the longitudinal transverse marking. Next one is 4-lane divided road on carriageway with more than 7.3 meter, and for 7.3 meter road with the traffic lanes, line marking is made continuously where stopping side distance is not available at a vertical and horizontal curve, but shall be applied for a short section to avoid provocation by restriction no overtaking in an one direction multiple lane car. Here you can see one direction multiple lane is provided, and in this there should be no overtaking. It should be the driver should drive in their lane, and there is many lane they can overtake, but in safety, and so that there is 4-lane division road in a carriageway, and the width of that road is more than 7.3 meters. Next one is road stud. Road stud are usually used across the carriageway to serve as speed arresters, coupled with skimming wearing through the creation of rumbling sensation on the user. And these colors for road stud: white to indicate the traffic lane line and the center carriageway, and red is mainly to denote left hand edges of running carriageway, and yellow is aimed to delineate the right hand edge of the running carriageway, that is multiple lane divided carriageway, and green is green road stud is to employ to indicate the crossable edge line. These are the colors of road stud, which tells about different things. As you can see, here are the road stud for a bi-directional road. You can see here the different colors are used. You can see in this image and the spaces provided. You can see here red and white shows the bi-directional, and yellow shows the bi-directional, and white and red also shows the bidirectional. And this where it is used, you can see bidirectional road stud red and white, and same bidirectional road stud is used as white and white, and bidirectional road stud used in yellow and yellow. This will be used in different places, and this will be this can be a normal section or varying section or overtaking section, and this colors will indicate according to the section that can be normal section, varying section or overtaking section. Road stud for devising carriageway color mate and lateral placement. As you can see here, pavement shoulder, and here is 50 mm AG center line and extreme left lane, you can see here, and extreme right lane, and here is a yellow color marking in the pavement, and that is desirable 100 mm clear direct distance from the vertical facing of riser of curb to the road stud, and it is marked in yellow color. As you can see here, here is undirectional road stud is in red color. Undirectional road stud can be in white color or optional, and it can be white color, or undirectional road color can be yellow. Yellow, this red, white and yellow can be used for, as I have told you, it can be used for normal, or you can see in this image, it can be used for normal section, or it can be used for wearing section or overturning section. Next one is road stud for diagonal and chevron marking. As you can see here, chevron marking is for diverging, and chevron marking for merging, and diagonal marking. As you can see in these images, bidirectional road stud red color at 2 meter, 4 meter and 6 meter, that is spacing same at the spacing of diagonal marking, and this shows that there are two way lane and we should not cross from middle. That middle one is for public, they can walk or stand or bypass the road. As you can see in this three images, that is first one is diagonal marking, that is second one is chevron marking for merging, and chevron marking for diverging. Next one is stopping and giving way marking. This image shows the stopping and giving way marking. As you can see in this, this is stopping marking and giving way marking. This shows that you can go from this way or return from this way, and you can take a turn, U-turn here, and take a U-turn here, and this image shows about that, and this this all markings is given on road traffic for safety movement of passengers. Next one is lane change marking and nose length in a multiple lane highway. As you can see, here are multiple lane in highway, and these lanes are subdivided. Here you can see it is divided into branches, and as the road goes on in same direction, the branches of the road get increased, and you can go for the safety movement. And mid of this slip road shows for the public, or for a road, if the vehicles breaks down, they can stand in this and they can repair their vehicles, or if the passenger want to bypass or get down, they can get down in these places. As you can see the marking, here is entering nose length, and here is accelerating length, here is existing exit nose length, and here is de-accelerating length, as you can see in this image. Then is marking for road hump. As you can see, here is the marking of road hump, which is placed here, and this chord length of road hump is marked, and this is marked in geometrical detail for road humping. You can see here desired speed, they can go here 20 25 30 35 40 45 50, and the radius in meter is 11 15 20 31 53 80 113, and chord length is 3 3.5 4 4.5 5 5.5 6.5 8 9.5, and the bus speed during the passing the chord, and the passing chord the speed is mentioned for a bus, that is 5 10 15 20 25 30 and 35. According to that, the marking of road hump is placed. As you can see, this road hump will be in this form. Pedestrian crossing. This image shows about the pedestrian crossing. If you want to see about this, you can see a note in an unusual signal crossing, signalized crossing, pedestrian crossing marking shall be around 2 to 3 meters for stopping lane. This will show, as you can see, this signal is placed on both the side and this marking is placed. This marking shows about the pedestrian crossing. If the any vehicles is crossing, people can stand here and give hand and bypass the road for their safety movement. Okay. Next one is no parking. As you can see, here is the symbol of no parking, and it will be placed on the road. And if suppose here is muddy road or cut road or repairing road, they will place this signal, and there should be no stopping or vehicle should be done, as you can see in this image. Next one is marking for object adjacent to a carriageway. All the objects located within 2.5 meter for a shoulder or curb shall be pointed as painted. As you can see here, as I have taught you about curb in last unit, you can see different types of curb should be painted according to the different type of pavement is used. Next one is varying center line. As you can see, here is the varying center line. Here are the center lines. The varying line is used to indicate that it is inappropriate to cross over it due to traffic condition. The marking indicates the boundary between the lane intends for travels in a opposite direction. This is the varying center line, and if this is two-way lane or two-directional, they can pass. One vehicle can go through in the that side of the white line, and one vehicle come in this side of the white line. That is varying line. Next one is non-overtaking center line. As you can see in this, these are the images of non-overtaking center line. They should not overtake the center line from this, and they should go in one direction, and they should not take over in this way. They should not take overtaking, as this yellow line marking shows that non-overtaking center line. Double center line. This you can see in the middle of the lane, there is a double center line. Double solid line means no passing of any direction. A broken yellow line parallel to a solid means a traffic on a broken side of a road can pass when safe to do so. White center line separates the traffic movement in a same direction, and this line is the most noticeable on one-way street. As you can see, here in one direction there are two lane, and in opposite direction there are two lane. As you can see, there are two lane in both the direction, and this yellow line it shows that there should be no overcrossing of this line. Next one is traffic signal. Traffic signal are a symbol are easily means for communication that lets the road user remains aware of basic traffic laws, along with a given warning and information about the location and the nearby enmities. As you can see, here are the traffic lights shown in red, yellow and green. As we know, red tells us to stop, and yellow tells us to get ready for the moment, and green tells you to move from that place. The summary of this lecture is all about the road marking, and this is very essential, and the essential purpose of road marking is to guide and control the traffic on highway. This supplement the function of traffic signs, and the marking serves as psychological barrier and signify the delineation of traffic path and the lateral cleanliness from the traffic hazards for safety movement of traffic, so that road marking should be provided for ensuring the safety of passenger as well as avoiding the accidents. I have referred from online source SK Kannan book and Retu publication book. Thank you for listening this lecture. If you have any doubt, you can clarify with me. You can contact me or you can message me. so that I can clarify your doubts. Thank you for listening.